morning, everyone.
Good morning.
We are glad that you're here on this cooler Sunday morning. It's a little overcast, but we'll take the rain and we'll take the cooler temperatures. We hope that you're glad to be here. If you're able, will you stand as we begin our service singing the call to worship, "I Will Call Upon the Lord." And you know, as we sing it, it's all right to smile. Did you know that? I know some of you it's hard, but... I will call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from my enemy. I will call upon the Lord. That desire to worship you in spirit and in truth. We thank you for each person that's here, each individual, each family that is represented. And Lord, we ask that you would be with us this morning as well. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And you may be seated as we welcome our worship leader, Tim Mayo.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
It's a nice day. It's nice to have the cooler temperatures here, a little rain once in a while. Puts a whole new aspect, a whole new view out there when we walk outside. Start out with, we need to do the housekeeping. There's a red booklet on the end of each pew. If you would sign in on those, pass them down. And also on the bulletin, there is a tear sheet. If you'll fill that out, if you have any prayer requests, or whether they're public or private, you can fill that out, place it in the offertory as well. We would appreciate that. Most of the announcements have been on the bulletin. Is there any others that need to be made? I know we have Vacation Bible School starting tonight. It's good to see the kids here. Hopefully we'll have a full herd of them tonight. And that God truly blesses that time. I know he's already done it because Melissa's here and is going to help with it. So God's already active in that part. The other thing to be noted is Melissa is here. And we will be taking a love offering at the end of the worship service for her and her mission that she's working on. There's no other announcements to be made. This week, something struck me as strange. I was watching TV, and I happened to see on one of the TV stations, they were doing an interview with Steven Tyler. I don't know if you know him. If you grew up maybe a little younger than me, he used to be the lead singer for Aerosmith. And they were talking about how his life of drugs and being the lead singer syndrome made his life what it is. And they were talking about it being refreshing and honest. And I'm thinking, you know, we grew up with something like that back when, in the 60s and 70s, when we had the British invasion. And I can remember watching TV, the Ed Sullivan Show, and all the girls going crazy and throwing themselves at the Beatles. And just going hog wild, you know. And you just wonder, what is the deal? You know, we sit there and we'll throw ourselves at singers. And maybe not just singers, but maybe somebody of power. You know, maybe a millionaire or something like that. We all try to buddy up to. But yet God, we like to hold off at a distance. And we look at what the difference is. You know, sure, a singer can put a song out there and a little snappy tune and stuff. So I looked up the attributes of God. 15 of them is what this study gave. He's infinite. Always has been, always will be. He's immutable, meaning he never changes. He's also self-sufficient. He's omnipotent, meaning he's all-powerful. He's omniscient, meaning he's all-knowing. He's omnipresent, means he can be everywhere at once. God is wise. God is faithful. God is good. God is just. God is merciful. God is gracious. God is loving. God is holy. And God is glorious. And he's all those things, but yet we want to hold him off at a distance. And we'll change our outfits. I remember growing up in the 60s and 70s and an older brother coming home with bell bottoms and flowery shirts, and all of a sudden the hair started getting longer when we didn't do that thing. And we change our lives for somebody we don't know, but yet God, we hold off. We're getting ready to do a men's Bible study on Saturday. It starts the 18th. And we're going to use this book. It's called The Measure of a Man. And the very first question it says is, if you know God, how would you change your life to walk with him? What changes would you like to see in your walk with God? And so that's why we're here today. That's why we're here in worship. Is because we want to walk closer to God. And that's what we're after today. Having nothing else, I'd like to invite you all to stand up and greet one another. Take our chairs, and if we can have the ushers come forward. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this opportunity to come before you on this day, a day that you have given us, the opportunity that you provided, the relationship that you only can offer. We just thank you for everything that you've done for us in the past, in the future, and right now. And we just praise you for that. We just thank you that you can put this glorious song
in our heart, the trust, the love, and the mercy that you bestow upon us. And we just thank you for everything that you've done. We offer this token offering. But more than that, we offer ourselves to you. We just pray that you use us and guide us and help us to give freely to those around. In your love and in your mercy. In thy name we pray. Amen.
Everybody wants to go their own way, but Jesus knows our every move, and he came to rescue me and you. Our God proves his love for us.
Stand if you're able, we'll sing our hymn of worship. If you're following along in the hymnal, it'll be on page 437, Send the Light, verses 1 and 4.
we go to the Lord in prayer. Father God, we thank you so very much that you are. We thank you for the many attributes that you display in our lives, and we thank you that Tim shared some of those with us this morning. And as we assemble together this morning as a body of believers, Lord, we thank you that you are so faithful to us. You are so loving to us, so merciful to us. And Father, we just come and we unite this morning because of our great love for you. Lord, we lift to you these requests that have been shared. And Father, we ask that you would work in each of them, that your will would be accomplished. We pray for Fred Jensen, who has been hospitalized because of pneumonia, Lord. We ask, Lord, that your hand would be upon him, that you bring healing and strength to his body. We pray for the Redding family as well, that you would watch over them and encourage them. We pray with Terry Sager and her family as they are traveling, Lord, that you give them safety despite the difficulties that they faced over this last week. Father, we lift to you also the Gillard family. We pray for Michelle and Austin as Michelle has lost both of her grandmothers in a matter of days. Father, we just lift them to you and pray that you would give them comfort and peace during this time. We pray for Joe McMillan and ask that you continue to encourage him and give him strength and encouragement. We lift to you Jeff Lanter and Austin Fleming, those that serve in the military and that are away from their homes or in their families, Lord. We lift them to you and pray that you would bless and encourage them this day. And we know, Lord, there are many other things on our hearts and in our minds. But as this day we assemble together this morning to prepare tonight, too, for Vacation Bible School to begin, we ask, Lord, that you would bless and work in that situation, in that program this evening. We pray that you would prepare the hearts of the young people that come, that they would hear the truth of the message of salvation through Jesus Christ and him alone, and that they would hear about their need for that. We ask, Lord, that you would bless each person that's working and leading and helping in whatever capacity. And Lord, we just pray that you keep the weather good for us throughout this week. And again, we just pray, Lord, that you would be glorified in all that we do and all that we say. And again, we lift you, Melissa Crawford. We're so blessed to have her here this morning and pray that you would just help her to feel so welcome in this community throughout the next several days for your glory. In Jesus' name we do pray. Amen. You may be seated. And at this time, we're going to have our scripture reading, and we have some special scripture readers for you today. And you know who you are, so now is the time.
Great Comprehension, 19. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations.
We're only standing.
Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in their name of the Father and the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you, and behold, I am with you always to the end of the age.
And he said, Go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature.
Then the pastor said to the servant, go out into the highways and hedges and complete them to come in, that my house may be filled. But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witness to me and in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth.
Let's pray. Father God, we thank you for your word. We thank you that it is truth. We thank you for the call that you give us through your word to share the truth of the gospel of Jesus Christ, to share your message. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You may be seated. And this morning we have kind of an interesting lineup. You know, generally we would have a sermon, and I know some of you are going to be disappointed that the pastor is not going to give you his normal 45-minute sermon this morning. Oh, there they go. Instead, he's going to give you a 55-minute sermon. No, just kidding. Oh, yeah. We have visitors here, folks. Anyways, what we're going to do today in sharing, thinking along those verses and in preparing, of course, for VBS, you know, one of the things that makes me so proud to be pastor of First Baptist Church of Clay Center is our mission heart. We have a heart for missions. And part of the truth of that we've seen this past summer with Laura Beth and Jared going to South Sudan. And they're home now. And Michael Brinkman is home from Alabama. And we'll hear from them later. But this morning we have the opportunity, we're going to hear about three other ways that our church has been involved in missions. And we're going to start, those of you who may recall that last week, two very, very brave adults from this church led a group of nine to South Dakota. And my bald spot has gotten bigger as a result. But we're going to invite those that were on the South Dakota mission trip, or mission visit, really. Come on up, those of you that, come on, even if you're not going to talk, you can come. There's a spot right here you can hide. Yeah, that got him. All right. And, well, go ahead and have a step back. First, we're going to start with a short video. And I will tell you that our missionary visit lasted 56 hours. Don't think I counted, but it lasted 56 hours. And the video is about 6 minutes. So you're gonna get an overview of what we did over that 56 hours. All right. My heart is for you to talk with them about what they experienced. All right. Thank you. Well, did it feel like 56 hours to you? I know that some of the students at some point. Some of those hours went by a little bit faster than others, but that's okay. So what we're going to do is now just give them an opportunity to reflect and to share what was their favorite part about the mission trip. And again, we're not going to take a lot of time to do this because my goal is for you to pick one of these people and visit with them yourself, because a 6-minute video or having showing you the hundreds of pictures that I did take won't let you know what an impact it made like it will visiting with them. So Libby asked if I would let her go first, and since she's my daughter, I said yes. So Libby, what most impressed you?
I was impressed when we went to go see the buffalo. And I don't know if you saw, but the little boy in the picture, his name was Colton, and he was full of a lot of energy and ran in circles around, I think it was just Riley, me, and Dad for a long time. But to be more specific, my favorite part was when the buffalo started to chase Lucas for a little while. And I thought it was quite funny, but I don't think he likes that. Anyway.
Anyway. Lucas, did you want to share any embarrassing stories about your sister? All right, well, we're going to move on. Riley, since you're here.
My favorite part was giving them the snow cones because it was nice of us to do something for them.
And everyone that got a snow cone also got what?
A tract.
A gospel tract, and we told them that God loved them. And so we did that for quite a while. I'll come back to you. Did you want to say something? No. What was your favorite part? We rehearsed this. Here, just stand there. What was your favorite part?
Swimming pool.
All right. Skylift.
My favorite part is the hot tub.
The hot tub. Okay. Angel? Mm-hmm. You don't know? Okay. Okay. Can you think of it? Let me know. Nathan.
The restaurants.
The restaurants. Spoken like a teenage boy. All right, and Lorraine.
My favorite part was getting a sunburn while telling a little Indian child that Jesus loved him. And when I told him that Jesus loved him, he said he does. But he also, we talked about how wonderful heaven would be. And he just and I asked him, would you like to go to heaven someday? He looks at me and he says, no, I'm scared of heights.
Well, one other thing that we want to say is we, as those that participated on this trip, want to say a big
thank you
to the church for its support of the youth program and the mission program. We appreciate it very much. And although I know they say, well, they like the hot tub and the pool and the food, but as we left there, it's hard to leave without having it really to make an impression on you. One of the things that I thought was interesting was that several of the ways that they practice their religion are parallels to things in our Christian faith. For example, that medicine wheel, it was interesting going into that spiritual room because he talked about how they would bring the departed into that room and the family would sit with them in there. And we have a picture too of in their hospital there, there's a sign that's actually posted that says, don't even think of parking here, which I thought we should let Austin know about for our hospital. But that medicine wheel, they were talking about the colors of it are the same colors of the wordless book that we use when we try to share the gospel message to people. And that's what Ed uses. He uses the medicine wheel, but uses the gospel message in it. We were also in that tribal ritual site. They talked about the Sundance arena. It's a Sundance arena. And in there, there's a lot of parallels with the story of Jesus. There's a tree that is selected. There is a virgin in the community that nurtures the tree. There are people that go there and they pierce their flesh in order to save their people. And so their view of it is totally skewed, but you can, you know, it's a way that Ed is able to share the truth of the gospel with them. But it was very interesting to get to interact with the people of that community. So we were blessed, weren't we? All right. So you all may find your seats now. Thank you for sharing. And again, pick one of them and share, ask them to share about their experience. The second thing that we want to share is, we've got another short, it's about a minute and 12 seconds long, another video. And this has to do with the medical supplies that were shipped to Guatemala. Linda Yarrow asked that we share this, and there it is. And there's no music or anything that goes with this one. Oh, yes, sir. And I'm going to just share a couple paragraphs of what Linda has left for us. It says, as a result of a recent expansion and renovation at Clay County Medical Center, the Clay County community was able to support a Maya physician in Guatemala who is building an 8-bed hospital in San Pedro, La Laguna. Linda Yarrow, a registered dietitian at Clay County Medical Center and instructor in food nutrition, dietetics, and health at Kansas State University, met Dr. Francisco Mendez 3 years ago on an education trip to Guatemala. Dr. Mendez works in Guatemala's Lake Atitlan region, and I'm probably pronouncing that wrong, where about 30% of adults cannot read or write, and 50% of the children are chronically malnourished. Dr. Mendez also works in a private practice in Guatemala 2 days each week to fund his rural clinic, and he is starting a public hospital in the rural area where 80% of the people don't have health insurance. Dr. Mendez grew up during Guatemala's Civil War, when about 170,000 Mayans died or experienced government-approved disappearances. Because he is a Mayan, Dr. Mendez was at risk, but the Catholic Church gave his family protection because he wanted to become a priest. In high school, he decided to become a doctor instead, and the church continued to protect him because their region needed medical assistance. Dr. Mendez studied medicine in Guatemala City in the U.S. before returning to his home village. Building the hospital is a slow process because he relies on donations to fund the efforts. CCMC was able to support his efforts by donating medical supplies and used medical equipment. Additionally, the Franciscan Ministry Warehouse in Independence, Missouri also donated medical equipment and supplies. After receiving the donations, the next step was to raise $10,000 to ship all the equipment and supplies to Dr. Mendez. And through the generous support of the people in Clay County, the state of Kansas, and across the U.S., the money was raised in less than a month. It says, on July 12th, 16 volunteers, and some of them you probably recognized from members of this congregation, 16 volunteers loaded 18,000 pounds of equipment and supplies into a 40-foot container, and the shipment was sent by truck, rail, and boat to Guatemala. Dr. Mendez will now have everything he needs to furnish 8 hospital rooms. He will also have equipment for surgeries and outpatient care. As a result of Kansas Connections, KU Medical Center is now sending medical students to work with Dr. Mendez, and a KU surgical team will perform surgeries in the developing hospital this fall. The ability of other medical teams to perform services for the Maya people is in part due to the donations Dr. Mendez received from the hospital. It was truly a community effort, and valuable support was received from the hospital. Maintenance personnel at the hospital, Heartland International Ministries, the Franciscan Ministry Warehouse, the Clay Center Community Improvement Foundation, First Baptist Church of Clay Center, and Kyle Bauer, who donated storage space, Tom Nelson of Tom's Feed Store, Key Feeds, GT Manufacturing, and Cunningham Repairs. It says additionally, many people from the Clay County community and across the state of Kansas donated valuable time to fundraise, and also spent 2.5 hours in very hot temperatures to load 18,000 pounds into the shipping containers. The shipment is scheduled to arrive in Guatemala City on Monday, July 30th. So you know when that is?
Tomorrow.
That's tomorrow. And from there, it will be loaded onto semis and trucked to San Pedro. And Dr. Mendez has stated this is a dream come true. There's still much more work to do in order to complete his hospital. And if you want more information, you may visit with Linda Yarrow, who is not here this morning, but you know who she is. But again, it's just another piece in the puzzle of serving the Lord, reaching out to those people in Guatemala, letting them know that the Lord cares about them. And sometimes you do it through medical missions.
May I add?
Yes.
The part that you don't see on those pictures were when Linda came home from Guatemala the first time, and she shared in our Sunday school class, just a bunch of women, she said, I think the Lord's calling me to do something. So we just prayed with her that she would see what it was. Then this all began to come about with the hospital here, having materials and et cetera. And then she came to, you know, we've been praying all along with her, and she came to us as the class and said, we've got a trucker that's bugging me to send this stuff, but we have to raise $10,000 in 1 month. And all we said was, well, we can't do that, but God can. And we began to pray. So what you don't see on those pictures is God working in the hearts of many, many people throughout the area, just, and it was all coming together, and it was so obvious that it was God working there, that we want to praise Him. We want to thank you, but praise Him.
All right, well, does that put a smile on your face? All right, well, keep that smile, because now we are fortunate to have Melissa Crawford, who we met her last April, as she came and visited and shared about the work she's doing for the Lord in the Philippines. And she is here this week with our Vacation Bible School because it's a sports theme. And so she's agreed to come and share a greeting with you as well. So will you give Melissa a good First Baptist Church of Christ and a welcome?
All right. Thank you so much for allowing me to come. My name is Melissa Crawford, and I am a missionary in Metro Manila, Philippines. Since I was here, we have started several new ministries. The most recent ministry we started is our kids' basketball. I got the idea in about October of last year that it'd be really cool to mix our kids' GM ministry with Corey Lyons and our basketball ministry together and reach kids. So what we did is we started praying about it. I met with Corey and some of his leaders and talked to them about what it would look like for Kids GM to give a lesson during kids' basketball. And in April, we were able to have 4 different workshops for kids' basketball at 2 of our existing churches and at 2 of our church plants. And we saw over 100 kids come to know Christ during that time. We were able to help those church plants get to know more people in their community, and they're planning to launch their churches by the end of this year. And then we were able to start a continuing weekly basketball Bible study for kids at 2 of our churches. So in January, we built a 5th floor on our main church in Pasig, and that is where I host basketball every Saturday morning for little kids. The money that you guys are raising this week for a storage facility is for that area. We're going to be putting on a steel gate to protect our basketballs and build some shelves in there so that we have storage and that I don't have to drag basketballs up four flights of stairs every Saturday. I also keep them at my apartment, and my apartment is not real big, so I'll be excited to get them out of my place. So thank you so much for being a part of doing that. I also have had the opportunity to be working in the Rizal High School, which is across the street from our church. At one time, it had 42,000 students in it. That's a lot of people. It was the biggest high school in the world for several years. It currently only has about 12,000 students in it, which is probably more than Clay Center, right? Yeah. So there's lots of opportunities there. We've been having a women's basketball Bible study after practices on Monday nights. And on Thursday nights, we have a Bible study for the softball team. So I've been helping at softball practice and basketball there once a week and having those Bible studies. Our women's basketball ministry continues to grow. We've been averaging over 20 every Thursday night. We've had several saved in the past year. We are praying that God will use the core of our group, that they will not only know Christ, but that they will change their lives. Because several of them have accepted Christ, but we haven't seen much change in their life. And I think that if we could have one of our core girls that has come for over a year now make a big change in her life where they can really see God working in her life, we're going to see a lot of other girls change their lives. And those girls, all they want is to be accepted and loved. And that's what they've found with our group. A lot of the girls that have come to women's basketball were lonely. They didn't have very many friends. And what they have found is girls that accept them for who they are and love them. And we want them to know Christ and to want to share that with others. We've had a couple of girls recently ask about how they could be a part of volunteering and leading our women's basketball. And so we've explained to them that they need to go through discipleship and start attending our church. And so we are praying that these girls will start attending on a regular basis. The girls' basketball is one of the things that I have the biggest heart for because I see the need. They need Christ so much. They are, like I said, lonely, and they don't have a lot of hope in the world because they are struggling. It's not real acceptable in the Philippines to be a girl that plays sports. You are definitely stereotyped, no matter what you are stereotyped. And so they need the gospel, and they need a loving church family. And so pray for them as they keep coming to basketball that we will see their lives changed by God. So that's a little bit about what's been happening. It's been encouraging to hear about your guys' missions. These little kids that went on this missions trip, it may not have felt like they did a ton while they were there, but it's important for them to see missionaries and see what the work is like. I went on three missions trips before I decided that I was going to be a full-time missionary. So I encourage you to talk to them about what their favorite thing was and encourage them to go on another missions trip as they continue to get older, because that's typically how missionaries get to the field, is that they go on a missions trip and God really touches their hearts about something either there or somewhere else in the world that they need to know more about Christ. So I'm excited to be here for Vacation Bible School. This is my fifth church Vacation Bible School in the past 6 weeks. This will be my fourth time to do Game On. So I feel like I know the moves to the songs. I know the words to the songs. I pretty much have this VBS memorized. So it'll be fun to be here and just to get to know everyone. I never have done this where as a missionary I've gone to other churches for Vacation Bible School, but it's been a huge blessing because normally missionaries are here for Sunday morning only, and we don't really get to know the people of the church. But me being here for the entire week, I'll be able to get to know lots of you better than just, oh, I recognize you from last time. I'll actually know your names and maybe know a little bit about you. So if you have time this week and you're volunteering at VBS, get to know me. I would love to get to know you. Even if you aren't volunteering, come check it out one night and see what it's all about, because this is a great VBS. They're going to learn about the gospel. There's no doubt that the gospel is taught during VBS, especially through the songs and the lessons. They will know exactly how to get saved at the end of this week. And so that's a huge encouragement. Invite people out to VBS, and we're going to have a lot of fun this week. So thank you so much for having me here today.
right, this time we're going to invite, we're almost done. Can you believe it? It has been a blessing, hasn't it? I know that the sanctuary feels a little bit weird today because we've got three windows closed up. And in case you're wondering, no, Jacob Cutshall didn't go crazy and smash the glass. They're being refurbished, and so it's a constant process when you have a building that's over 100 years old and stained glass that's over 100 years old, you know. So it'll be a couple weeks or so while it's a little bit darker in here. That just means you need to smile a little bit bigger. All right. But if the ushers will come forward, we'll prepare to take our special love offering for Melissa. Again, we are so thankful that she's here. As she said, one of our mission project for VBS is to help her to get the storage that she needs for her work there in the Philippines. All right. And one other thing that you can do, if you can talk to some of the elementary and teen kids and ask them how you say good water in the Philippine language. But just be prepared, all right? Let's go to the Lord and pray for the offering. Father God, again, we give you thanks and praise. We thank you for your word that tells us to go, Lord, and we thank you for the opportunities that you give us to go. And we thank you for the many people part of our community and our congregation that not only do respond in going, but also those that pray for that. We lift you, Melissa, and we thank you for her sweet spirit and her willingness to come and share this week. We pray, Lord, that you would bless her in a mighty way. We ask that you would bless in this offering as well, that every penny that is given would be given as unto you, and that Melissa would receive it with a heart of Christian love and support and encouragement. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We'll be taking offerings every night during VBS, so if on Tuesday you think, hey, I want to continue to give, don't hesitate. And you know what? If next Tuesday or three Tuesdays from now or a year and a half from now you decide you wanted to give to Melissa, it's always a good time, right? All right. All right. Well, will you stand as we dismiss in prayer? Father God, we do thank you so very much for the opportunity to come together this morning and hear about what you're doing in the life of different people in this church as relates to missions and in the life of this church as a whole. We pray, Lord, that you would help us to always stay focused on the truth that people need Jesus. And Lord, we pray that if there are any here this morning that perhaps haven't yet made that choice, that you would speak to their heart, that you would encourage them to ask questions, and I'd be happy to visit with them, Lord. But Lord, we ask that as we leave this place now, that you would go with us, that you would bless this day and bring us back this evening ready for Vacation Bible School. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you.
I hope I didn't do it.